Good morning.
Good morning.
Your June special monthly offering will benefit Lutheran Disaster Response. Seniors and Friends Luncheon this upcoming Thursday at Osgood's at 11:30. That sign-up sheet is on the kiosk. On Sunday, July 7th, St. Paul's Relay for Life team will be running the concession stand at the Fleetwood Park. There will be two concerts that day, so we need help in the concession stand from 2 to 5 or from 5 to 8 p.m. See Cindy Tobias or Betty Buss. Also, volunteer bakers are needed for those concerts. Due to the high heat today, cookies at the cross will be served in the fellowship area. Please stay for some refreshments. This time I'd like to introduce our pastor, our president, Tim Hefner.
Well, we had a council meeting on Tuesday night, so I didn't remember that part of the agenda.
So I can go home.
But what I would like to pass out to the congregation this morning is on Tuesday night at our council meeting, we did install Claude Osterley as a council member for the rest of this year until our voting meeting in December. I guess he missed Cindy on a Tuesday, on the third Tuesday of the month, so he was willing to come back to council. So we really appreciate him coming forward and continuing to serve the church council and also the church. And also, I would like to mention that if you look at the financial report in the bulletin, it's showing a $26,334 surplus of expenses or surplus versus the expenses that we have incurred this year. So we are showing that we are ahead of budget or ahead of expenses with contributions, but it's actually a misleading number. It's a good thing to have, but if we would have a permanent pastor on staff, we would not be showing that amount of surplus. So continue to share your gifts with the congregation so that we can continue to grow our financial stability here at the church until we have a permanent pastor installed. So at this time, I'd like to introduce Pastor Fox to lead us in worship this morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I hope this is working. Can you hear me? Okay, I think it is. Well, I'm so happy to be back here today, and we are here to praise the Lord. We have a special praise service in store for you today, and with you today, because you need to be praising the Lord with our worship leadership. And so you will see a few things that are different. I don't think anything is different that will throw you off. Just follow the bulletin as we go. But before we begin, let's stand if you are able and share in our confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy.
Amen.
Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life and feed us for the life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, There is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven and loved into abundant life. Amen. Now, please refer to your bulletin and share with me the reading of Psalm 100 that you will find there. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name, for the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. Let us pray. O God of creation, eternal majesty, you preside over land and sea, sunshine and storm. By your strength, pilot us. By your power, preserve us. By your wisdom, instruct us. And by your hand, protect us. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Most everybody's sitting. I'm not sure whether we're to be standing or sitting, but if you're standing, you're in the minority right now, which is fine. It's fine. Maybe as we sing along, everyone will be inspired to stand as the inspiring hymn.
Call your name. Will you call her in the name?
The first lesson is from the sixth chapter of 2 Corinthians. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, at an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on the day of salvation I have helped you. See now is the acceptable time. See now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacles in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commanded ourselves in every way, through great endurance in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and in dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing and yet possessing everything. We have spoken frankly to you, Corinthians. Our heart is open, is wide open to you. There is no restriction in our affections, but only in yours. In return, I speak as to children. Open wide your hearts also. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God. If you're able, please stand for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 17th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. I wasn't sure what to expect in terms of attendance on a summer Sunday, especially a very hot summer Sunday, and especially families and children who are so busy doing other things. So that's why I kind of am merging my children's message and my message. And I'm so happy we do have at least 2 children here today. And I'm wondering now, are you sitting with your grandma and grandpa? Oh, well, no wonder you're faithful in worship during the summer. I bet your grandpa's had a big influence on you in that way, right? Maybe. Nora and George. And I think I saw at least one other little head bobbing over. Yeah, I saw... I think I saw at least 1 or 2 other children back there. Please come forward if you would like to. No pressure. But if you want to get into heaven, no, I won't go there. Here's a young at heart. I have something to show you today. Oh, good. Good to see you. Now that we have some older children, You probably have seen these, but I really don't know whether you've ever seen one of these or not. I have different varieties. Do you guys know what these are? Do you know what those are, Nora? Stamps. Have you ever used stamps? Yeah, what do you use them for? Have you mailed something? Yeah, do you remember who you mailed it to by any chance? No. Well, these are the ones I brought. Then there's a lot of different stamps that come out all the time. Do you know who this little guy is? And that little doll, have you ever seen that? Charlie Brown, right, and Snoopy. And they've been in the cartoons for years and years, but you probably see them most at holidays when, I think Charlie Brown has a show about a Christmas tree, you see, maybe Halloween too. And let's let Nora, what's your age, honey?
Seven?
Do you know what the word says yet?
Thanks.
Thanks, right. These are thank you cards. These are kind of going out of style too. Like Charlie Brown and Snoopy, they've been around a long time. And I'm noticing fewer and fewer people are writing thank you notes. But I'm making a big pitch here that it's a good idea to write thank yous. And I know a lot of people say thank yous on their phones. Where is my phone? I could write one right now to somebody real quick. I wouldn't even have to think about it. And someday later, they may forget that I said thank you. Or if they want to remember what I said, they wouldn't be able to find it because it would be up there in what they call the big cloud in the sky being saved for something. But they couldn't read it again easily or have memory. So that's one of the good things. If you write thank yous, people can go back and it kind of records your history. And I wanted to show you this as a thank you I got recently. And I had four children in confirmation class, the church I was last serving. Four of them. And two of them were really active and talkative and outgoing and in all kinds of school activities. One of them was in dance, and she wasn't quite as talkative, but she was very pretty and a good dancer. She did a ballet in our Christmas program. One of them was in a different school district, and he was very quiet and shy. And he didn't say much, and I never got to know him very well. But lo and behold, when they were confirmed this spring, I wasn't the pastor then, but I went because I had taught them for almost 2 years, and I liked all of them. And I gave him a little card with a little Dunkin' Donuts gift card. My granddaughter suggested that, Dunkin' Donuts. Do you like Dunkin' Donuts? Okay. Well, if you want a little gift card, you could ask me to confirm you someday. So of the four, I got one thank you note. And this is who it's from. Now, can you guess? Do you want to guess which one I described them? Two boys and two girls. The shy one? You're a smart, intuitive guy, aren't you? Yeah. The shy one, do you think his parents put him up to it? Probably. At least they suggested it, because kids don't think about this at their own. But I was so touched, and I was so impressed. And this will go in my little packet of cards, and 10 years from now, I'm going to remember this boy, and I may have forgotten the other ones. And he wrote it himself, and he said couple real nice things in there. I was surprised because he never talked much. And what if those four people, what if I'm an employer? Well, maybe I decide to buy a business. And all four of those people someday apply for a job. How much do you think this will weigh into my decision? Little weigh in. It might not be the deciding factor, but I'll definitely know that this is a thoughtful boy who can express himself and took the trouble to take a thank you card and put a stamp on it and mail it away. So I'm going to give you all a thank you card. You have anybody right now you could think about sending a thank you to? I see somebody sitting right beside you, I bet, would love to. I'll tell you, if nobody else appreciates a written thank you that comes through the mail, it's going to be your grandparents, for sure. And the stamp always goes up here in the right-hand corner. So you take an envelope, and you can pick your stamp. Only there's only one flower. You have almost the same flower in your dress, so would you like the flower? Okay. Do you know where to put it on your... on your envelope? Yeah, up in the corner. And these are guitars. Ooh, should give one of these to all of our praise team members. Anybody want the elephants? You wanted an elephant? Do you want a flag? Okay. Do you know where to put it? Maybe Nora can help you. You want a flag? Anybody want a guitar? No? Well, we're hoping to groom you for the praise band. All right, so you got your envelope. You've even got a stamp on it. And here's your card, and sometime today, maybe, if you can't think of somebody, your parent or grandparent or aunt or friend will have an idea for you. You know what, if you wrote a thank you to your teacher, it would mean the world to her or him if you could find out where they lived. That would mean so much to your teacher, and even more so to the principal, who probably doesn't get much appreciation. Okay, thank you for coming up. You can go back now. So praising God is all about saying thank you. That's what praising God is for. And that's really what worship is for. And praising God is not just a Sunday thing. It's not just a once in a while thing that we have a praise service. It's not just a mealtime thing. It's not I get to go to Disney World thing or whatever kids look forward to doing. It's not just, yippee, I won the lottery thing. Praising God is an all the time thing. Or hopefully we would learn to praise God all the time. It becomes a 24/7 thing. The closer that you walk with the Lord. Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him in the evening. Praise Him at supper time. A little chorus goes. A lot of choruses I learned in camp and vacation Bible school went through my mind as I was thinking about this praise service. Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him in the evening. Praise Him at supper time. I try to live by this principle. I try to thank God before I get out of bed in the morning. The first thing I thank God for is my pillow. I'm quite attached to my pillow. But just to have a soft pillow under your head when you wake up is a gift that many people in the world could not even imagine. And I go from my pillow to my comfy bed with a pillow top. And I'm fortunate that I still have a loving partner next to me in bed that I can thank God for. And the list goes on and on. It's early in the morning, and when I realize I have to rally myself and get the dog out, my words of praise become a little less loud. I tell myself, thank you, God, for this nice little dog, in spite of all the commotion she causes. And it gets harder as the day goes on, I will admit it. As frustrations set in when the temperatures rise, when prices rise, when one becomes fatigued. I try to look at the day and weigh the good things against the bad things and praise God that there are always good things, even on the worst of days, to thank God for. You know, the first lesson was so important today because we think of Paul as one of the most committed followers of Jesus, committed his entire life to preaching the gospel. And if you listen, you can read it again for yourself. All the things that Paul was up against, things that none of us will ever suffer, imprisonment and being shackled and beaten, and the list goes on. And yet Paul said, I have learned to give thanks to God in all circumstances, in all circumstances. So I charge you to think of that. And even, you know, when you're in pain, even when you're in a dull hospital room where you're not getting the attention that you would deserve, even when you're stuck in traffic, even, you know, when you look at your bank account, I just have been caring for a friend whose husband died. You would never think that this couple, by all appearances, were fairly well off. But he was trying to keep a business going and kept, unbeknownst to her, kept borrowing money. And he died very suddenly and left her basically with nothing but her meager Social Security income to cover a lot of bills and to figure out how to move forward with her life. And she praises God. She's a deeply spiritual, religious person. And she can talk about this literally with almost a smile on her face, saying he was just such a generous, kind person, not expressing one bit of angst towards him, but of course, concerned for how the future will go. The future will go well for her because in all circumstances, she has learned to thank the Lord. Praising God is not just a Sunday thing. It's not just a mealtime thing. It's not just a sometime thing. It's really our purpose for being. It is the meaning of our lives as Christians. It's our responsibility. It's our joy to it in all times, as our communion liturgy says, in all times and in all places to give God thanks and praise. Amen. Please stand if you are able.
In sky, I have heard my I'll do this from here. Please join me in confessing our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He was Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. I like to think of myself as not only a pastor, but a teacher of the faith. And a couple of things I'm going to mention before we invite you to share joys and sorrows. I noticed your creed is still has not been updated, I think, what you would find in the official publications of the church, where you say he descended into hell. These are the two most asked questions about the creed. What does that mean, Jesus descended into hell? Anybody want to take a stab at that? We clarify it in our more updated version of the creed by saying he descended to the dead. And perhaps you would want to make that editorial change. He descended into hell, I always said, is, first of all, he really suffered. He didn't just body and soul didn't just fly away to glory. He truly did suffer the worst that life can throw at you. And secondly, and as is clarified in the more updated version, he truly died. You know, he wasn't just in a coma. You know, he wasn't hidden away by his disciples and, you know, showed up later. He truly did die. He descended to the dead and rose again, as the creed says. The other most asked questions is, what do we mean by the Holy Catholic Church? Anybody Catholic in here? Raised Catholic? Oh, yes, okay. So you probably like hearing that, right? Or not. The most important thing to notice is it's a small letter C, not a capital C. It's not a proper noun referring to the Roman Catholic Church, which is a proper noun. We capitalize the first letters of proper nouns. It's a small letter C, and if you look it up in the dictionary, Catholic means universal. So it means that God is over all churches of all expressions. There's a lot of different ways to express our praise and worship. And none of those churches that believe that Jesus is Lord, God's Son, our Lord, are excluded from that universal Catholic understanding of God's oversight. So any other questions you'd like answered this morning? We, as opposed to a praise service, Lutherans historically have worshipped in what's called a liturgical service. That's our form of worship, and the easiest way to understand it is it's pretty much the same from one Sunday to the other. We call it the liturgy, and it's the same from one Lutheran church to the other, although that is changing. And the creed, as I mentioned, is a good example of that, where the word is changed. But when you come into church on Sunday morning, you pretty much know how the service is going to go. No surprises. No pastor's going to stand up and say, well, I'm going to teach you something this morning, as I did. And it's downloaded now from the publication of the church into the bulletin, and a part of that are the prayers, the prayer petitions. You may have wondered, where these prayers come from? Who's writing these prayers we're saying? They may sometimes not reflect your concerns or even your convictions. They come down from some universal place. Most all Lutheran churches use the same prayer petitions every Sunday. And I've noticed that even in saying that, it's pretty repetitive from one Sunday to the next. You know, there's always a prayer for creation. There's always a prayer for national leaders. There's nothing wrong with that at all. I just want you to understand we're not doing that this morning. I'm just going to say a prayer, and it's going to be short, shorter than this. But I wanted to, it's really prayers of the church, which is you. You are the church. And hopefully these prayers would reflect what's on your heart on a Sunday morning. And so I'm inviting anyone who would like to share a joy or concern to say so at this time. I know it's a little unusual, especially for Germans, to speak up in church, but if there's anything in particular? All right, we're going to do this again. Oh, Pastor.
Inside her leg to fill in the cavity there.
How interesting.
It's a miracle that she's with us, that Larry and
Missy are here. Or Missy, his wife. Larry's.
Missy is daughter.
Yeah. Oh, daughter. Hi, Missy.
Hi.
Glad to know you got such fast attention.
It's a miracle here that she could have bled to death if she hadn't been in the hospital visiting her husband.
This would have been a hard praise service to do if that had been the case. We're so happy and thankful, Missy. Anyone else? Sometimes, yes.
I just want to share that the Life had the wrap-up meeting on Thursday night, and we are so blessed to have Mark and Cindy Tobias. They led this entire group, and the final count will be over 136,000 dollars. That was this. And of course, you can support them by coming down on the 7th of July, like Cindy said.
That's wonderful. Any other joys or concerns? Let's all be thankful for air conditioning. I feel so bad for people that may not have it. And sometimes our blessings come in very small ways. And then I saw a couple walking as I came to church this morning. They both had hats on, an older couple. I think they're here now. But it was just a blessing to see, and I could tell they were on their way to church. I'm not 100% sure it was this church. That would be an extra blessing. But it's just a blessing to see people actually walking, number one, walking together, obviously, very strongly partnered together. Walking to church, that is a message in itself. That's a way that we testify to the world that God is good and worthy of praise. So let's just bow our heads now for a short prayer. Gracious and holy God, we just have so much to be thankful for. Even as we count our blessings, we pray that we never lose concern for those less fortunate. And yet we also recognize that in their own time and place and lives, they too often are blessed with the same things that mean so much to us. Favorable weather, family that give us love and support, friends that draw us out of ourselves and cause compassion for those that are not us, and certainly always having food to eat and shelter. And we thank you for calling the church into being. Where else do we go to share in different age groups, different walks of life, as we walk into this place, sharing a common form of praise and worship, sharing a faith that sustains us, brothers and sisters who share their joys and sorrows as the years go by. Thank you for calling the church into being. Thank you for our musicians this morning that did such a good job leading us in song. And Lord, we just pray that we leave here today, our hearts lifted, joyful, in spite of all the problems of the world, joyful, knowing that you have the whole world in your hands and will someday make all things right and welcome us into that perfect kingdom over which you reign. We pray these things. We also just pray quickly for the Neffs, Missy and Larry, thanking you for that miracle. And we thank you for all those that participated in Relay for Life. And we pray for those people whose lives will be sustained by those funds that are collected to offset hunger. And any other joys and concerns that lie on people's hearts. Lord, hear our prayers and bless our lives and our service. In your name, the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. And now we turn, we worship. We actually worship with our offerings, giving back a token of what God has first given to us.
I invite you to join us in singing Lord, I Lift Your Name on High. As this ensemble was rehearsing this piece, somebody suggested invite the congregation to join us. So it should be projected up there. Thank you.
Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self and called us to the feast of plenty. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us to be what we receive here, your body for the love of the world, life of the world. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in your name. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
It was in the night in which he was betrayed that our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those
who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Christ has set the table with more than enough for all. Come, and you may be seated. I invite those communing in the pew and those communing with us over Facebook Live and YouTube to commune at this time. Body of Christ given for you. The 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 body of Christ given for you.
God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us, mercy on us, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you break the chains of hatred and fear. Have mercy on us, mercy on us, mercy on us. justice and peace. Have mercy on us, mercy on us, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you are the way of mercy and love. Have mercy on us, mercy on us, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you'll take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace, grant us peace, grant us peace.
Amen.
Praise to you, O God of mercy. Thanks be to you forever. Raising high the weak and lowly. Thanks forever. From of old you loved and taught us. Thanks be to you forever. Faith and justice you have taught us. Thanks be to you forever. Strong is your governance. Strong is your love. Remembering your covenant of life with us. Praise to you, O God of mercy. Thanks be to you forever. Raising high the weak and holy. Thanks be to you forever. Thanks be to you forever.
I just wanted to take a moment to thank the praise team for leading us this morning. So thank you so much for joining us. I'd also like to thank my older brother, Bob Hinckley, for joining us with guitar this morning. So thank you so much, Bob. Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray. Amen. 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 Go in peace. You are the body of Christ.